This is Greg Troutwine with Maritime Reporter TV. We're here today with Vigleik Takle of Kongsberg. And Kongsberg has just announced a major acquisition. And Vigleik is going to add some perspective to that announcement. So Vigleik, first and foremost, thank you for joining us. I appreciate it, and I appreciate it's busy, unique times.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So as you know, and I believe it was in our the May edition of Maritime Reporter where you wrote on the software outlook for 2020, the field of maritime software solutions is a crowded one. So my first question, just to start us off, simply is, why coach, why now?
Yeah, no, I think we're seeing a consolidation in the software market now, and there's a lot of these really good companies that have grown, but reached a plateau where they're not able to grow any further given their size, their brand, and so on. And that's how we came about with Coach, which we saw have had a fantastic journey up until now, steady growth, very happy customers. And we saw that, okay, it's a very good fit into what we are doing. There are some basic building blocks that we have not focused on, but we are seeing that the market still wants these more basic solutions to begin their digital journey. So it's a very good fit. And then, of course, when these type of companies come out in the market, we want to be part of getting them on board. So the timing was great. Again, the team and the product impressed us. We know about them before, but of course, when we started the dialogue, we saw that it was much more into this company than what we believed. Especially on the people side. So yeah, it was a perfect fit, I would say. And very excited that we were able to get the deal closed.
Okay. So, and specifically, I think I understand what you're saying, but I guess what specifically did Coach bring that Kongsberg already did not have?
Yeah, so in Kongsberg, we have focused a lot on the IoT side of the vessels. So bringing in sensor value and then build applications on top of that. Whereas Coach have the reporting tool, a very easy reporting tool. But of course, a lot of data, very relevant data, is being reported from the vessel every day. And then they build solutions on top of that. So it's that gap where if you don't want to have an IoT solution on board your vessel, and there's still it's still an emerging market, of course. So there's the majority still rely on the new reports and build applications around that. So that's why it's a good fit, because it's the basic data set that you can get from the new reports and build solutions on top of. And then the natural next step in any digital journey will be to go into more advanced type of solutions, capturing sensor data, which is our strength and has been our focus.
When you look at acquisition versus organic development of a software solution, can you just point out some of the pros and cons of acquiring a company of the technology or developing it in-house yourself?
No, I think in terms of the technology these days, it's very easy to build similar applications yourself. It's very little unique. There's so much open source. There's so much good frameworks to build software. So it's, or at least for us, we don't buy companies based on their software. Okay. We buy it on the people, the domain knowledge, the skill set that they bring to the table, and of course the footprint they have in the market. I would say those are the two main parts. So could we build the same software ourselves? For sure. Not as good, because we don't have the same domain knowledge. We don't have a 5 years experience delivering these type of solutions in the market. So it would be not as good of a product. It would take us 5 years to get to where they are in terms of market size. So it's all of this timing and domain knowledge, which is the two, or the main knowledge, I would say, is the main ingredient here.
Yeah. Okay. Just one more question. I don't think I can have a conversation today. I don't think I can have coffee with my wife without mentioning COVID-19. So when you look at what's going on in the world around us, obviously this is a major business disruption event that is going to impact everything. The way I put it to my kids. In your business, which is increasing the levels of automation and connectivity and digitalization on board ships, how do you see this event impacting your mission?
That's a good question. No, I think for the last 2 years, we have talked a lot about the underlying drivers pushing the market towards digitalization, like regulations, like the high focus on cost efficiency. But I think what we're seeing now with COVID-19, it's probably the biggest driver of them all. Of course, it's a bit too early to say, but I think more and more are starting to see the benefits from utilizing digital solutions, like remote operations from the vessel. It's become a necessity, right? Because suddenly you're not able to fly service engineers around the world to fix things. So in the middle of the pandemic, we actually enabled remote support in our solutions and very good feedback from the customers. And I also think that just the fact that we're now starting to see or everyone's enforced into digital solution, I think a lot of the skepticism and conservative people are starting to see it, but there's something in there that it's actually working. It's not only buzz. I'm optimistic. Of course, that being said, there's no question that there are going to be tougher times in our industry. So then it's a question of, yeah, people see the need, but do they have the willingness to pay for this type and invest into these type of solutions? I think so. I think what we're seeing now with more and more documented use cases where customers are going forward and showing what they have achieved by adopting digital solutions with very strong ROIs is going to be really key into this transformation. But at least on our side, we are very positive and yeah.
Okay. So, and again, just one final question. I apologize. It's one that I just like to ask, particularly, like you said, we're in the middle of we're in a transformation period. Where are we in that transformation period? Are we at the very beginning, or how do you term it when you have casual conversations with your friends and discussing what you do and the industry that you serve?
Yeah, so that's a good question. No, I think we are very early days. Very, very early days. I think it's, of course, there's always someone who is a few steps ahead. But generally speaking, we are very early days still, I would say.
Well, Vigleik, again, thank you very much for your time. I know it's busy times. I know it's exciting times with the acquisition of Coach, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Okay. This is Greg Troutwine with Maritime Reporter TV.